We're destined for good things. We're destined for good things. We're destined for good things.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to this episode of the Q2 Theory. I'm your host, JC, and today we're going to go back into examining the Quadrant 2 theory. Specifically, today we are looking at Quadrant 3. That's right, Quadrant 3. And we're going to evaluate it. And I wanted to really look at this quadrant because I was hanging out with a friend and I noticed that he was actually in a state in his life right now where he's really dealing with tasks that fit into quadrant three. Now, just to do a quick recap, we've gone over quadrant one. These are things that are both urgent and important. We've gone over how you need to take care of these things and handle them immediately, top priority on your list. We've gone over quadrant two. These are things that are important but not yet urgent. These are things that you want to schedule time for and get ready and prepare for them and do them in advance before they come urgent. Things that are going to make you a better person, things that are going to benefit those around you. Now we're going to hit into quadrant three. And again, quadrant three is specifically for the tasks that we do that are urgent but not important. Now these are the sort of tasks that are very big time wasters. These are tasks that can have us running around, that can have us running to and fro, feeling stressed out, feeling, you know, like we've got the weight of the world on our shoulders, if you will, going around and doing things that have deadlines but are not important for us to do. The problem with Quadrant 3 tasks is that they are almost specifically designed to waste our time. You see, the very time that we use to run around putting out these urgent but not important fires is the same time that we could be using to further our goals, to reach our Quadrant 1, to reach our Quadrant 2 goals. And that's the danger, is that quadrant three tasks rob time for everything that we could be doing in our quadrant one and our quadrant two that can make us better people and help us to get closer to our goals. And so I'll help you evaluate your own lives and our own lives so that we can look at ourselves and see what sort of quadrant three tasks we're doing. If the tasks that you are doing are not important to helping you accomplish either your life goals or your career goals, you must realize that this task is a quadrant three task. Even if it might be urgent, it might have a deadline, but if it's not helping you get closer to your goals, it is something that is urgent, even though it is not important for you. And I'll give you a few examples. Maybe you desire to be a police officer, but you're spending all of your time at the local butterfly catching convention. And I'm using something silly, but remember, it's the principle that's important. So pay attention to the principle, even though I'm using a silly example. So you might be wanting to be a police officer, but you're spending all your time at the butterfly convention. You're going out catching butterflies. You are practicing your butterfly catching skills 1, 2, 3 hours every weekday. You're going to a butterfly convention 2 to 3 times a week. You're on multiple butterfly catching teams. You're doing all of this butterfly catching related activities, but you know you don't want to be a professional butterfly catcher. You know that it's not really a life goal, a career goal for you to be a butterfly catcher. You want to be a police officer. You want to be a law enforcement. You want to be a law enforcement officer and dedicate your life to keeping people safe. But you're spending all of your time doing the butterfly catching thing, and it's got deadlines, okay? So you've got to be to this place at a certain time. You've got to be to that place at a certain time. You've got to practice at certain times. You've got to catalog at certain times. You've got to go to the conventions and the events twice a week, and there's a time, and you have to be there on time. And so you've got all these butterfly-related tasks that are urgent, but they're not important to your goals. Likewise, whatever the case may be, you might want to be a film producer, and yet you're just spending all of your time doing nothing other than watching television, watching TV. Now you might say, well, if I want to be a film producer, I need to watch TV, I need to watch television, get a feel for the industry, stuff like that. But on the other hand, while you might need to watch some things, actually I could get into that, you specifically only want to watch the best things. You don't just want to watch anything if that's what you're going to do. If you're going to be a film producer, you watch the best, you don't watch the less, because you're you're going to produce what it is that you watch. So you want to make sure that you're intaking the best so that you can produce the best. When you produce the best, you'll become the best. So you don't even just want to watch anything. But even more than that, if you want to be a film producer, you don't want to just spend 24/7 watching TV, watching films that aren't going to help you be better. You want to be spending your time learning about the actual industry, learning the laws related to the industry. Those are going, getting internships. These are going to be an experience. Internships, learning about the industry, learning the laws. These are the things that are going to be your quadrant one, your quadrant two, not sitting down and watching film and TV all day. Okay. And so you see, in the same way, like with the film thing, you might say, well, I've got some benefits by sitting down and watching TV or film as much as I do, right? I want to be a film producer, so I want to learn, I evaluate the films, I evaluate sort of what they do, sort of the behind the scenes, things like that as well, so I'm getting some benefit from it, right? Well, here's the thing about quadrant three task. Benefits that come from quadrant three task, we can get those benefits and greater by focusing on quadrant one and quadrant two task. Any benefit that you can get, if you want to be a film producer, going back to that example, the benefits that you might be able to get from just watching a ton of movie and TV content, you can also, you might say, well, the behind the scenes or the evaluating, things like that, you can get much more benefit of being able to evaluate behind the scenes, being able to learn how things are done, being able to learn how things happen behind the scenes. You'll actually gain more knowledge and information in that by getting a good book or getting in contact with people who do it, or getting an internship, or getting learning about the laws in the industry. You'll get that benefit and more by focusing on tasks that are actually quadrant one or quadrant two. So in the same way, examine your life. What things are you doing that aren't helping you towards your goal? What things are you doing that are taking up time and have urgent deadlines but are not helping you towards your goals? These are things that are quadrant three tasks, and these are things that you either want to delegate, use in minimal free time, but you don't want to expose or use up the majority or even half of your time tending to quadrant three tasks. Now, sometimes quadrant three tasks are tasks that others place on us. These are things that might be important for someone else, but are not important for us. Quadrant three tasks can be hard to get rid of if you're somebody who has a problem saying no. But just simply realize you can politely say no when a no is called for. Okay, it is perfectly fine when somebody comes to you with this, with an urgent, unimportant task that you either, say no, you just can't do it right now, or if you have a scheduled set time where they can speak with you about those things. You see, because people have to, when you start doing that and, you say no, when you can't take on a quadrant three task and you say, no, I can't do this. Or if you have set time, you're like, okay, so I'll devote, I can spend XYZ time, amount of time per week, maybe 1 hour a week for quadrant three task. Then you can say, okay, I'll have time to speak with you during this set period of time. You can call me then. This way, people will realize that not only are you there to be able to assist them with the quadrant three task, but at the same time, they realize that your time is valuable and they'll begin to respect your time more. So don't be afraid to say no when a no is called for. Let's do it like this. Let's say you want to be the police officer. You're getting ready to do your quadrant one task, your quadrant two task. You're like sitting down at the computer, getting ready to look up, okay, what police academies are in the area? What opportunities are in the area? How can I, get more involved right now with this career that I want to have in the future, right? How do I do that? And you're looking up and you're finding out this information. Then you get a text from a friend. Hey, there's a new butterfly convention going on in the area. You have to come. You've got to come to this convention. There's a deadline. You've got to come. You got to try out in order to be considered worthy to come to this thing. They're looking for 5 butterfly presenters. You've got to come to this thing. Let's go. Let's go. There's a deadline. Let's do this. We've got to do it now. Come on. Let's go, butterfly, right? It's okay to say, no, I can't do this right now. I've got other things to focus on. I won't be able to focus on butterfly catching as much as I have been in the past. However, I do have Friday from 2 to 3 open. Whenever you want to go butterfly catching around that time, please let me know and we will go butterfly catching on Fridays from 2 to 3 p.m. Boom. And this way you're saying yes to the person, you're showing the person you care about spending the time with them. However, you're also showing that your time is important and you just have other things that you've got to tend to. And that's perfectly fine. Anyone who is a true friend, anyone who is true family to you will have absolutely no problem with seeing that you are going about focusing on accomplishing your goals. And in fact, you might even be able to find something that's quadrant one or quadrant two that other people, your friends, your family can join with you in doing. For example, doing videos and stuff. This is something that I've been doing for a little while, but in different arenas, both, weddings, short films, things like these. And I had a group of students, friends, and my siblings that we got together and we produced short films. So I was getting to spend time with my friends. I was getting to spend time with my siblings. We were creating the relationship, creating the memories. But this was also something that not only did they want to do, but it was also something that was catering towards my quadrant one, catering towards my quadrant two. So I got to spend the memory, make the memories, I got to build the relationship, and I got to do something that was moving towards my goal, that was moving towards helping me accomplish what I wanted to accomplish. So in the same way, in addition to setting aside time in a week that you're willing to use just for some of these, for any quadrant three tasks that might pop up, you also want to find areas, specifically for this task, because I realize sometimes these tasks are things where they're not towards our goals, they're not helping us in any way, and they're taking up a whole lot of time out of our schedule. However, we're building a relationship with someone we care about. We're making memories by doing these things. I want to find something that's quadrant one or quadrant two that can fill those same slots. So maybe you want to be the film producer. Well, your family, you can run by your ideas, by your family members. Hey, I had this idea for this film. I had this idea for that. What do you think about this? Get their opinion, get their feedback. People like being able to give feedback when they know that their feedback is going to be listened to, is going to be heard, right? Or even maybe if you want to be that film producer, after you're done with projects, after you're done with videos, show it to your family, let them see and let them give you feedback before you release it, before you put it out there, before you publish it. These are certain ways that you can both be working in your career or working towards your career and in your quadrant one and your quadrant two and still be making memories, still be building relationships with your family members. For example, back to the police thing. Police officers have, especially the youth camps and the young adult camps and such, they have certain competitions and certain feast days and campouts type of things. Maybe your family can come watch you compete. Your family can, maybe your dad can help you with practicing whatever important things at home that are related to being an officer. There's a lot of stuff they show you, whether it's the grappling or the this or the that. Maybe your dad or your brother can help you with that when you're at home and help you practice and such like that. You can find things within your quadrant one, within your quadrant two that you can use to build relationships while at the same time staying away from quadrant three tasks. And a good example, an example of this that we'll all be familiar with, or most of us will be familiar with, is Akila and the Bee, right? So let's look at Akila, because she really lived this out. She lived out this principle in her life, and we got to see this inside of the movie, okay? So when we look at Akila, she decided and realized that her goal, her passion, her goal was to become a spelling bee champion. She wanted to win the spelling bee. You remember that scene? I want to win the bee, right? When she's talking to her coach.
You want to win what?
And that was her goal. Now, in the beginning of the movie, she was doing a lot of quadrant three tasks with her friends. She was going to the mall, she was shopping, she was just chilling around, she was just, going out to eat, spending hours and hours every single day doing quadrant three tasks, whether it was just going to the mall or just going out to eat or just, you know, just chilling out, just hanging out, you know, quadrant three. Some of these were quadrant four tasks, which I'll get into in a different video, but others were quadrant three tasks. Whereas, you know, if she was going to go to the mall, she didn't have a car. She had to catch a ride with somebody, which means specifically she was catching a ride with her mom's friend or with her sister. So there were, these are people who have set times. If you're going to come to the mall with my daughter or whatnot, then I'll be there to pick you up at XYZ time. That's a deadline, which means there's an urgency. Whenever there's a deadline, there's an urgency. So she was having quadrant three tasks. You know, at this time, I've got to be, I can't be studying. I can't be doing anything because at this set time, I'm being taken to go to the mall or being taken to do XYZ. And that was her life until she realized all of these quadrant three tasks were taking her away from her goal, away from her desire to win that spelling bee, her desire to be the best that she could be. So what did she do? She had to withdraw from the quadrant three task, withdraw from the quadrant four task, which again, we'll get into in a different video, so that she could have time to spend on her quadrant one task, her quadrant two task. And when she did this at first, yes, her friends and her family members did not quite get it at first. Okay, why aren't you going to the mall with us anymore? Why are you spending all your time studying? Why are you doing this? Why are you doing that? At first, they did not get it. But what you saw in the movie is that her true friends and her family members who truly cared about her, eventually they did realize, it didn't take them too long, but they eventually did realize that she was going about doing something that was towards her goal, accomplishing what she felt she was here to do. And you know what? Her true friends, her family, ended up helping her to do it. And you see that great scene where she's jump roping and you know, keeping time while all of these different people in her life are helping her study and practice for that spelling bee. What happened? She's getting to get this. She's getting to spend time with her friends. She's getting to spend time with her family. She's getting to build relationships, make memories, all of these great things that she was doing with them at the mall and at these other places, except now all of that is being done and she's focusing on her quadrant one and her quadrant two task, all of these things that are going to get her to her goal, get her to accomplishing her dream. And not only does she build the relationship and she focus on the quadrant one and the quadrant two task, but she gets to that spelling bee and she nails it. Why? Because she took the time necessary to focus towards her goals. And she was able, and all of the true friends, all of her fam, her true family helped her. Once they realized what she was doing, they helped her and motivated her and supported her to accomplish it and to accomplish her dreams. And that's what each and every one of us have to do. We have to get rid of the quadrant three task as much as possible. Now, it doesn't mean that we can't ever do a quadrant three task like go to the mall or whatever, or catch butterflies or whatever have you. But we need to schedule minimal time for those and focus maximum time to our quadrant one and our quadrant two. And we can find things within these tasks that we can use to still build relationships and make memories with the people we love. This way we'll be able to make the memories while becoming who we want to be, while preparing for our futures. And when you do this, minimize quadrant three, maximize quadrant one and Q2, and you'll find yourself in a better place in life in the future. And you'll look back on your life and be happy that you spent all your time the way you did. You won't regret the way you spent your time, because not only did you get to make the memories, but you also got to better yourself and prepare for the future that you'll be living when the future becomes the now. With that being said, thank you all for watching. Be on the lookout for Quadrant 4 video, which will be coming out soon. We've got a lot of great, great content coming out for everybody. Got some more videos with Malia coming out. Big cool mini series that Malia and I are going to be doing. It's covering consistency. We also have a consistency challenge, which is going to be coming out soon. So be on the lookout for that. Lots of great content coming out. Post your thoughts, your opinions below. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. It is your subscription, your support that helps us to continue and to continue releasing new content. If you have anything you want to let me know, you ever want to talk to me, feel free again. We read the comments, or you can contact me through Twitter. You can I also post updates and different things like that on Twitter, and you can contact me directly by tweeting at the Q2 Theory on Twitter. Thank you all for joining, and you can watch more videos right now. And remember, we're destined for good things. Peace.
Hulkritude.
It's derived from the Latin word pulcher, meaning beautiful, isn't it?
That's correct.
P-U-L-C-H-R-I-T-U-D-E. Hulkritude.
Congratulations, Akilah.
You know that feeling where everything feels right, where you don't have to worry about tomorrow or yesterday, where you feel safe and know you're doing the best you can. There's a word for that feeling. It's called love. L-O-V-E. And it's what I feel for all my family and all my coaches in my neighborhood, where I come from, where I learned how to spell.